Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will find out the stability factor for the voltage divider biasing circuit. Now if you have followed the previous videos, then we have already discussed about the voltage divider biasing circuit. And we have already seen that how we can find the expressions for the base current, the collector current and the voltage VC. But let me just quickly go through the procedure which we have followed during the analysis. So what we did, we found the Thevenin's equivalent circuit for this voltage divider circuit. That means we found the Thevenin's equivalent resistance RTH and the voltage VTH for this voltage divider circuit. And then by applying the KVL equations on the input and output side, we got these expressions. Now during the analysis, often we write this collector current IC as beta times IB. But actually it is given by this expression. But usually, as this reverse saturation current is in the nanoampere range, so this second term is often neglected. So now, using these expressions, we will find the stability factors for this voltage divider biasing circuit. And first of all, we will find the stability factor S. So this stability factor S can be given as del IC divided by del ICBO by keeping the value of voltage VB and the ICBO fix. Now if we differentiate this expression with respect to IC, then we can write del IC divided by del IC is equal to beta times del IB divided by del IC plus beta plus 1 times del ICBO divided by del IC. Now if you notice over here, this del ICBO divided by del IC is equal to stability factor. So we can say that this term is equal to 1 by S. And here this del IC divided by del IC is equal to 1. So if we rearrange this expression, then we can write 1 minus beta times del IB divided by del IC is equal to beta plus 1 times 1 by S. Or we can say that S is equal to beta plus 1 divided by 1 minus beta times del IB divided by del IC. So this is the general expression of the stability factor. So in this expression, if we know the value of this del IB divided by del IC, then we can find the value of the stability factor. Now in the earlier video, we have derived the expression for the base current. But let us rewrite the same expression so that it also involves the collector current. So if we apply the KVL on this input side, then we can write voltage VTH minus IB times RTH minus voltage VB minus this V, that is the IE times RE, is equal to 0. Now here we know that this ammeter current IE is equal to IC plus IB. That means we can say that voltage VTH minus IB times RTH minus VB minus IC plus IB times RE, that is equal to 0. Or we can say that IB times RTH plus RE is equal to voltage VTH minus VBE minus IC times RE. That means the base current IB is equal to voltage VTH minus VBE minus IC times RE divided by RTH plus RE. So this will be the expression of the base current, which also includes the collector current. So now to get the value of this del IB divided by del IC, let us differentiate this expression with respect to IC. Now if you notice over here, this voltage VTH and the voltage VB are the constant. So whenever we differentiate this expression with respect to IC, then these two terms will become 0. that means del IB divided by del IC is equal to minus RE divided by RTH plus RE. So now let us put this value into this expression. That means the stability factor S is equal to beta plus 1 divided by 1 minus beta times minus RE divided by RTH plus RE. That means S is equal to beta plus 1 divided by 1 plus beta times RE divided by RTH plus RE. Or we can say that it is equal to beta plus 1 times RTH plus RE divided by RTH plus beta plus 1 times RE. Or if we further rearrange this expression, then we can write this stability factor S is equal to beta plus 1 times 1 plus RTH divided by RE divided by beta plus 1 plus RTH divided by RE. So this will be the expression of the stability factor for the voltage divider biasing configuration. Now as you can see, whenever this RTH divided by RE is much less than this beta plus 1, then this term can be neglected. And in that case, the stability factor S is approximately equal to 1. That means whenever this condition is satisfied, then we get the best stability of the circuit with respect to the change in the ICBU. But whenever this RTH divided by RE is much greater than beta plus 1, at that time this beta plus 1 can be neglected. And in that case, the stability factor S is approximately equal to beta plus 1. So this will be the maximum value of the stability factor. So similarly, now let us find the stability factor S dash. So this stability factor S dash can be given as del IC divided by del VBE by keeping the value of ICBO and the beta constant. So to find the value of this stability factor S dash, let us put the value of this base current IB into this expression. And by putting the value, we can write this collector current IC is equal to beta times voltage VTH minus VBE divided by RTH plus beta plus 1 times RE plus beta plus 1 times ICBU. Now whenever we differentiate this expression with respect to VBE, then the beta and the ICBU are fixed. That means this second term will become 0. That means del IC divided by del VBE is equal to minus beta divided by RTH plus beta plus 1 times RE. And this is nothing but the S dash. So this will be the stability factor S dash for the voltage divider biasing configuration. And similarly, now let us find out the stability factor S double dash. So this stability factor S double dash can be given as del IC divided by del beta by keeping the value of ICBO and the VBE constant. So once again, to find the stability factor S double dash, let us put the value of this base current into this expression. And if you put the value of this base current IB into this expression, then we will get this expression. So to find the stability factor S double dash, now let us differentiate this expression with respect to beta. And here, as the ICBO is constant, so whenever we differentiate this expression with respect to beta, then this term will become 0. So now this del IC divided by del beta is equal to ICBO plus RTH plus beta plus 1 times RE times voltage VTH minus VBE minus beta times RE times VTH minus VBE divided by RTH plus beta plus 1 times RE whole square. So basically, whenever we differentiate this term, then the first denominator is kept constant and the numerator is differentiated with respect to beta. And the second time, the numerator is kept constant and the denominator is differentiated with respect to beta. Now here, as this ICBO is very small, so we can neglect this term. And also in the numerator, when this term is getting subtracted from this term, then in the numerator, we will get RTH plus RE times voltage VTH minus VBE divided by RTH plus beta plus 1 times RE whole square. Now here we know that this VTH minus VBE divided by RTH plus beta plus 1 times RE is nothing but base current. Or approximately we can say that it is equal to IC divided by beta. So we can say that this del IC divided by del beta is equal to IC divided by beta times RTH plus RE divided by RTH plus beta plus 1 times RE. Or it is equal to IC divided by beta times RTH divided by RE plus 1 divided by RTH divided by RE plus beta plus 1. So this is the expression of the stability factor S double dash. So in this way, we got the expression of the stability factor S dash and the S double dash for the voltage divider biasing configuration. So similarly, in the next video, we will find out the expressions of the stability factor for the collector feedback biasing configuration. But I hope in this video, you understood how to find the stability factors for the voltage divider biasing circuit. So if you have any question or suggestion, do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.